We're checking out of the Retro Inn in Cortez. We're gonna go to Mesa Verde and then cliff jumping at a place called Adrenaline Falls. Anyway, today's our very last day
driving.
We're gonna be back in Denver tonight. And tomorrow we'll do some things in Denver, but this is the last day of the road trip portion. This park is huge. We've been driving for like 30 minutes and we're only halfway to where we're going. So after driving about an hour, now you have to walk.
6 months? Luckily it's not.
Crazy to think that people lived in these things. And it's pretty like impressive how they built them.
Imagine being the first person to find these.
Yeah, you'd be so confused. So up here on the left is an old gas station that's now all marked off with toxic waste signs because apparently their gas pump leaks underground. We made it to Durango, Colorado. We're on our way to a place called Adrenaline Falls, which is like waterfall with cliff jumping. We're about to drive through a forest fire, which I've personally never done before. It's clear on the right, smoky on the left. Going back, you can hardly see anything in this valley. Oh, wait, what if the place we're going to is on fire?
I think we're too far away for it.
Okay, good. There's a helicopter carrying a massive bucket of water over there. Now, it really started to smell like fire, obviously, because we're driving through all this smoke. They have signs everywhere like fire staging, fire camp, so I guess they have a whole team here battling this fire. The sun is coming through the smoke and making really weird reflections on cars. Anyway, we saw this geyser thing on the side of the road, so I had to stop and look at it because it looks pretty cool. This is crazy, I've never seen anything like this.
Maybe I should not have been nice.
We found this road called Old Lime Creek Road, and we're just kind of looking around trying to find this place. Potato Lake Trail. So it said this road lasts for 12 miles. We're just gonna follow it, see where we end up. Because all the guides online say this is a road you have to take to get to where we wanna go. Some guys are in front of us in a truck. Found a little lake out here. to be the video guy?
Yeah, sure.
Get some driving shots.
So this has been, so we just talked to some people, and we could have gone the highway route, which would have been a lot faster and easier, but this is cool. This is an adventure. Some pretty nice sights and stuff. But nobody knows what we're talking about when we asked about the waterfalls. Yeah.
Damn, look, there's no barrier.
No, obviously not.
If you go off,
you're dead.
We're dead.
Yeah, so don't go off, bro. Our lives depend on you, no pressure. Oh my god, that's a deep fucking salt too, bro. Hold on, let me show the audience this real quick.
Yeah.
That shit looks hella deep, dude. So if we fuck up, this is gonna be our,
This is crazy.
Oh, so, really, yeah, what the hell was that?
Wrong.
Okay.
We did that.
Well, this my car is holding up like a trooper.
This is terrifying.
It is pretty
look,
terrifying.
This is the only time you'll see me with two hands on the wheel like this.
Yeah.
This is so scary. We're next to a cliff face right now.
Yeah. It's spooky. Hey, but it's 420 though. Let's get it. So we're gonna send the drone out. So just like take a look around.
Yeah, we're gonna fly. So we're gonna fly the drone up and take a look around and see if we can see the waterfalls. If not, we're just gonna keep driving. So we got the drone up in the air right now, and I'm 99% sure that I see our destination, Adrenaline Falls, on here. Figure out how to get there. I'm lowering in altitude so I can get a better look.
Is that car coming? The car with a dog running alongside it. Wait, let me see. I want to see this fucking battery. So the drone died. Where is it, Jake? Did the drone die or the remote? Yeah, I have no clue where it was lost. What? I can follow it. Oh, it tells you where it is? What? No. How close is it? All right, I'll go back then.
So, we were looking for falls we crashed. And fortunately, the app, it marked its last location. The thing was beeping. Whew. I ran back up.
Why?
Just wanted to get up quick. Found it. That one bust rotor.
Really?
But I'll replace it.
Oh shit.
Hey, at least you still have it.
Yeah.
Oh shit. Back here is busted. And it might be fixable.
Well, I guess that's the end for the drone for this trip. Good thing we're on the last day.
So we saw some locals come through here on a dirt bike and a truck. He said, if we go to the paved bridge, we're gonna miss the trail. And the trails will be marked with an A. So we just have to watch these trees to find an A.
No, we definitely saw it.
Okay, good. So now Tyler went that way. You found it? Keep looking around over there. We're looking for a trail marked with an A. Hey, I found an X. Found the big old X. X. So I'm just looking for an A, but if I get down to this bridge, then I'm gonna have passed it. Could be this that runs right along. That could be it. You know, we might have this backwards. Because when I read the thing again, it says driving down this road from the north end. That's the north end. So we go down, it says cross over the paved bridge, and then when you run into the aspen grove, stop and take the trail down. So maybe we'll run into another aspen grove this way. I'm actually somewhat surprised that we actually found this place. But I'm really happy that we did.
I'm not worried.
I'm not worried. I'm just surprised that we actually found it. I'm starting to hear a waterfall. Yep. This is really steep.
This is rough.
Holy shit. We're almost there. Oh. There it is. Right behind that tree that it's right there. Let's go.
Hey, dollar.
Hey, lucky dollar. There it is. Some nice rocks to jump off of. Now we just need to figure out how to get up there. Okay, so I'm gonna go down there, make my way up, and then jump off that rock on the right-hand side into the water.
Yep. First, he has to do this fucking hike. Right now, he's hiking up this shit. It looks really steep from over here, but I really don't know. Maybe I'm behind that tree right now. My hand's shaky. And he made it to the top. Alright, he's about to jump. From up there, down. Oh, actually not yet. This man's about to jump. We're up there, down in that water. Never mind, he's moving again. Now he's climbing. Down where he's gonna jump. Probably where he's jumping from is probably just about as high as Nelson's landing. Use your own judgment, man. I can't help you. Right, if you don't think you can, don't do it. Praying to God real quick. How cold is the water? How cold is the water? hold on. This is round two because he didn't think he could clear the jump on the right side. So even though he did it, we looked it up. It's the left side you jump off. So he's about to do it again. All right, you ready?
Oh, You got it! You got it! Just do it! Then you'll be down! Sooner you jump, the sooner you're down! Jump away from the rock! No, you won't! I was fine! I'm such a good friend, telling my other friend to jump off of a cliff. I feel like he's just making himself more nervous by sitting there staring at it. He just needs to jump. He'll be fine. Just do it. Come on, Tyler, you got it. Go! I'm gonna go rescue him really quick and I'm gonna jump. But I'll leave it here filming. I got up there and I couldn't remember where I jumped from. So I had to think about it. But then I just took a nice big leap and I made it. Do it! Jump right now! Jump! Yay, he did it. There we go. Left my mark. Yeah, adrenaline falls. Whew. I'm tired. Now we got our trip back to Denver. That'll end our road trip once we get back there. So we made it off of the dirt road back onto the highway. We don't have phone service right now, but we know that we just have to go north. That's the way back to Evergreen. So we're heading north and we're hoping that at some point we'll run into a little town where we could grab some food and eventually gas, because we have 170 miles left of gas. Found a really cool town called Silverton. It's way out here, in the middle of nowhere. This food looks great. We're on our way back to Denver now. Tyler's gonna drive it first, I'm gonna take a nap. And then about whenever he gets sick of it, he'll wake me up and I'll take over. There are, what even are these things?
Elk, I'm pretty sure.
Elk or some type of animal everywhere.
I'm pretty sure they're elk.
Yeah, the ones in Evergreen, they're not scared of cars.
Like these ones are scared because they probably
don't see cars very often. We've been driving for about 3 hours now. We're passing through Parachute, Colorado, and I'd say we have 3 hours left, so we're at the halfway point. Actually, we're probably a little bit past the halfway point, because it was about 6.5 hours total. It's currently 11:20, so we'll get there at 2-something a.m. Tyler, explain why you like this tunnel.
Well, because in case I get lost, there's always an arrow to point the direction where I need to go.
Yeah. That is a wrap. It's currently 2:30 in the morning. That wraps up our 3,000 mile road trip. I'm really tired, I'm gonna get some sleep. But my closing thoughts from the road trip is, if you get the opportunity, just get in your car and go, because there's cool stuff out there to be seeing. There's so much stuff around, just everywhere. Just go and drive, find stuff. So yeah, I'll see you guys on my next adventure.